So good morning everyone and welcome back once again to another class of PIB 247. In today's class we'll be talking about the PIB news from 24th to 25th of May 2023, and I hope your preparations for the upcoming examinations are going well. If you guys face any difficulty, you can connect directly to the team at this number 9999466225, or you can also text me on Telegram at Mashi Manish, MASHYMANISH. Okay, so let's talk about the very first question, which says, consider the following statements with reference to open network for digital commerce, and you have to identify the incorrect statement. Few days back, Kandima ma'am had also discussed about this ONDC. Today also it is there in the PIB release, in one of the PIB releases. So there are high chances ki is bar ONDC se koi question bane, right? So let's talk about ONDC. First of all, why it is in news? Because there is a program, ONDC Elevate. ONDC Elevate program has been recently organized in Bangalore, right? Where? In Bangalore, in Karnataka. Why this program was organized? On the occasion of completion of 1 year of the launch of ONDC, right? It was launched as a pilot project in the year 2022, Open Network for Digital Commerce. And that's why this program has been recently organized. But let's talk about what more important for us is ONDC. Theek hai, ONDC ke baare mein basic jankari hume honi chahiye. So let's talk about ONDC. Remember the objective, ONDC. What is the objective of this ONDC? To promote open networks for all the aspects of exchange of goods and services. Right? For all the aspects of exchange of goods and services over digital or electronic networks. जैसे हमारा Amazon होता है या Flipkart होता है, उसी तरीके से now we have ONDC which is open for all, right? That is the major thing, that is the major objective of ONDC. It was launched as an Section 8 company. ONDC is actually was incorporated as a Section 8 company, which means not for profit company, in the year 2021, but it was launched as a pilot project in 2022 in the month of April in 5 cities of India, which are Delhi, Bangalore, Coimbatore, Bhopal and Shillong, covering the entire country, right? And of course, remember, it is an initiative of Department for Promotion of Industry and Internal Trade, DPIIT, which works under the Ministry of Commerce and Industry. So if anyone asks you which ministry's initiative is this, the answer would be Ministry of Commerce and Industry, right? Talking more about it, remember the founding members were also Quality Council of India and Protein EGOV Technologies Limited. This platform is based on an open source methodology, wo uske naam se hi clear hai, using open specifications and open network protocols. So everything is open here, right? And it is modeled around UPI project to ensure that buyers and sellers of the goods in e-commerce market can transact regardless of the fact they are registered on which platform. Jaise UPI work karta hai, you have an UPI, right? And through that UPI, you can operate on Google Pay, on Phone Pay, on Paytm. Similarly, it will not matter where the buyer or the seller is registered. He or she can operate his e-commerce marketing, or he or she can sell his e-commerce product, or anyone can buy also. So, isse koi farak nahi padta ki aap register kahan pe ho, ONDC se aap khareed sakte ho, right? So that is all about ONDC. I hope this is clear. Let's identify the incorrect statement now. It is an initiative of Ministry of Electronics and IT. No. It is an initiative of Ministry of Commerce and Industry. It was incorporated as a Section 8 company in December 2021. Sahi baat hai. It was launched in pilot mode in April 22 in 5 cities, which are Delhi, Bangalore, Coimbatore, Bhopal and Shillong. And yes, you have to remember the name of these 5 cities. Important hai. Ye bhi sahi hai. Quality Council of India and Protein EGOV Technologies Limited are its founding members. Absolutely correct. It is based on closed source methodology. Nahin. Everything is open here in the open open network for digital commerce. Theek hai? So 1 and 5 are incorrect, which means option D. Yeah, option D is the correct answer. Let's talk about question number 2. Impacting research, innovation and technology, which in short is IMPRINT. Now there are high chances ki IMPRINT scheme se question aa jaye. Theek hai? Impacting research, innovation and technology scheme was launched by the Ministry of Education in 2015 to address major engineering and technology challenges in 10 selected domains relevant to the country's needs. Which of the following are included in the 10 selected domains? Kaun-kaun se included hai in the 10 selected domains? This scheme has been provided in the government schemes PDF. Enrolled students can read it from there. And aaj bhi hum iske baare mein yahan pe bhi discuss karenge, don't worry. So let's talk about imprint. So why imprint is in news? Because an exhibition took place through which the Ministry of Education showcased the outcome of the projects under the Imprint 2 scheme. And this exhibition took place at IIT Delhi. Where it took place? IIT Delhi. And remember, what is the full form of imprint? From the full form, you can easily identify the objective of the scheme, that is impacting research, innovation and technology. Impacting research, innovation and technology is the full form, which means what is the objective of the scheme? The scheme promotes research, innovation, right, and the use of technology in the market. Jo hamari pura research ka ya jo pura hamara ecosystem hai, puri economy mein as a whole, research, innovation and technology ke upar ye kaam kar raha hai, ye wali scheme, right? The objective of this exhibition is to bring forth the public-private collaborative funding for the research projects, right? Now, it was organized, of course, by the Ministry of Education and SERB, which is Science and Engineering Research Board, which works under the Ministry of Science and Technology. Right? And during the showcase, 60 projects under 10 domains of Imprint 2 were displayed. And now, let's talk about Imprint scheme. The objective, as I told you, promoting innovation, research, technology, that is the major objective of the scheme. But if I talk about word to word, so that is the objective of this scheme. To promote innovation of a higher order that directly impacts need of the industry and improve the competitive edge of the Indian manufacturing ecosystem. So as I told you, it is about the whole economy. ठीक है, क्योंकि अगर manufacturing में अगर हम बात कर रहे हैं और पूरी industries, सारी industries की basically हम बात करें तो all in all we are talking about the entire economy. It was launched in the year 2015 under Make in India by the Ministry of Education. And the scheme intends, through this scheme, the Government of India through Ministry of Education intends to bring forth the collaborative funding for research projects, jiski madad se we can create the products and the, you know, actually the innovative products, right? And what is the meaning of collaborative funding here? From the private players, right? Public fund to hoga hi, saath mein private fund ko bhi invite kiya ja raha hai isme. It seeks, this scheme seeks to address major engineering technology challenges in 10 domains, which are environment and climate, energy security, healthcare technology, sustainable habitat, water resources, advanced materials, ICT, manufacturing technology, nanotechnology, and security and defense. Now you don't have to read it, you know, you don't have to remember it word by word. Aise nahi ki baith ke rat rahe hain. You don't have to cramp it. Just read it 2-3 times. You will be able to identify or you will be able to answer the question if any such question come from the list of domain or which of the following is not one of the domain or which of the following are the domains. Agar iska koi question aayega, so you guys would be able to answer that after reading these domains 2-3 times. That is enough. And the institutions which are included for effective implementation of this scheme is IIT Delhi, IITs and Indian Institute of Science, Bangalore, right? Imprint 1 ki agar hum baat kare, to under the first edition of Imprint, 142 projects at a total cost of 313.30 crores were approved, right? And these projects were funded jointly by the Ministry of Education and the participating ministries in the ratio of 50-50. Okay, participating ministry, ek do nahi hai, there are various. So that's why I haven't put the names of all the ministries. And the second edition of Imprint was launched in the year 2018 with 1000 crore funding from the Ministry of Education. Alright. And this makes the scheme very, very important for the upcoming RBI Grade B examination. You can expect a question from this. Right. So now let's come back to the question. Which of the following are included? Energy security hai, advanced materials hai. Yes, quantum computing is not there. देखा तो मैंने 2-3 बार पढ़ा है तो मुझे इतना समझ में आ गया कि क्वांटम कंप्यूटिंग तो मैंने नहीं पढ़ा था. सो दिस इज हाउ यू कैन आल्सो रिटेन और रिकॉल द फैक्ट्स ड्यूरिंग द एग्जामिनेशन. नैनो टेक्नोलॉजी था, मैन्युफैक्चरिंग टेक्नोलॉजी ऑफ कोर्स था. तो 1, 2, 4 एंड 5 इज देयर. यस, ऑप्शन बी इज द करेक्ट आंसर. 1, 2, 4 एंड 5. लेट्स टॉक अबाउट क्वेश्चन नंबर 3. Where has the National Campaign for Updation and Verification of People's Biodiversity Register been launched? So first of all, the question is, what is the People's Biodiversity Register? Because based on that, a National Campaign for Updation and Verification has been organized. So we'll talk about it, don't worry. This campaign has been organized in Goa. This campaign has been organized in Goa by the Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change, National Biodiversity Authority, Goa State Biodiversity Board, and the government of Goa. Right? These four stakeholders were there to organize this campaign. Right? Now let's talk about what is this People's Biodiversity Register. What is this? Remember guys, it is a document which contains comprehensive and detailed information on locally available bioresources. Right? It contains information about locally available bioresources. And what is the meaning of bioresources here? Plants, animals, microorganisms and their byproducts. The products that we get from plant, animals and microorganisms, right? Including landscape and demography of a particular area or village. It serves as a comprehensive record of various aspects of biodiversity, including conservation, preservation and accumulation of knowledge, right? Talking more about it, it is prepared by Biodiversity Management Committees, BMCs. It is prepared by BMCs in consultation with the local communities. Of course, there is a major role of local communities here because they know better about the local biodiversity, right? And these BMCs have been constituted by local bodies in states or UTs as per the Biodiversity Act of 2002. Biodiversity Act hai 2002 ka, uske under ye BMCs ko banaya jata hai and they are being created for promoting conservation, preservation and spreading the knowledge about conserving and preserving the biodiversity of a particular area, of a particular region. Theek hai? So that is all about it. And where did this national campaign take place? Goa. Option A is the correct answer. Let's move ahead to question number 4. Which digital platform has been launched by Ministry of Parliamentary Affairs to make the functioning of all the state legislatures paperless by transforming them into a digital house? This I hope you guys have heard so many times, but this time abhi ye PIB release mein hai, so let's discuss it once again. Isko dubare se ek baar discuss kar lete hain. There is no harm in that. So there was a national workshop on the NEWA. What is NEWA? National E-Vidhan Application, right? There was a national workshop which was organized under NEWA in New Delhi, and that's why NEWA, which is National E-Vidhan Application, is in news, right? Now this workshop was organized to encourage all the state or UT legislatures to promote, to switch to the National E-Vidhan Application and make their houses completely digital, right? Jo pura state legislature hai ya kuch UTs jahan pe legislature unko completely digital banane ke liye, the government of India is promoting NEWA, right? And that's why this workshop was organized. Now if I talk about NEWA, that is National E-Vidhan Application. So the objective is to make the functioning of all the state legislatures completely digital and to convert all the houses, to convert all the legislatures into the digital legislatures. Theek hai? Taki jo paper hai, matlab basically paperless legislation sarkar karna chahti hai. The implementing ministry is the Ministry of Parliamentary Affairs. And this application is an end-to-end cloud-based digital solution for bringing all the 39 legislature. Now what is this? How there are 39 legislature? Lok Sabha, Rajya Sabha, 31 assemblies. Theek hai, jisme UT of Delhi aur Puducherry bhi hai, and 6 councils across the country. Theek hai ji? It has been developed on the theme of One Nation, One Application. Theek hai? आगे चलते हैं, इसके बारे में और थोड़ा सा जान लेते हैं. इट इज वन ऑफ द 44 मिशन मोड प्रोजेक्ट्स अंडर द डिजिटल इंडिया मिशन ऑफ द गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया. एंड अगर हम अभी तक बात करें तो टिल नाउ 21 स्टेट लेजिस्लेचर हैव साइंड एन एमओयू दैट दे विल इंप्लीमेंट NEWA इन देयर रिस्पेक्टिव स्टेट्स. एंड 17 लेजिस्लेचर जो आउट ऑफ दिस 17 लेजिस्लेचर के लिए फंड्स सैंक्शन हो गए. द फंड्स हैव बीन सैंक्शन फॉर द 17 legislature out of these 21 state legislature which have signed an MOU, right? And among them, 9 legislatures have already become fully digital and are live on NEWA platform. So, agar aapse aaj pucha jaye ki kitne legislature hai jo ki completely digital hai, completely NEWA platform pe hai, to the answer would be 9. Theek hai? So that is all about this, and Niva is the correct answer, option D. Let's move ahead to question number 5. How much financial support Ministry of Ports, Shipping and Waterways will provide for the promotion of green shipping under its Panch Karma Sankalp, right? So the Ministry of Ports, Shipping and Waterways has taken this Sankalp, which they are calling as Panch Karma, right? And there are 5 targets of the ministry under this Panch Karma Sankalp, right? And what are these? The ministry will provide 30% financial support for the promotion of green shipping. Green shipping ke liye 30% support diya jayega, number 1. Number 2, under Green Tug Transition Program. Tug basically wo hota hai jo ek bada ship hai aur chota ship jo usko aage khich ke leke jata hai, that is known as tug. So for Green Tug Transition Program, JNPT, which is Jawaharlal Nehru Port, VO Chidambaranar Port, Paradeep Port and Deen Dayal Port will procure 2 tugs each. Number 2. Number 3, Deen Dayal Port and VO Chidambaranar Port to be developed as green hydrogen hub. These 2 ports will be developed as the green hydrogen hub. Number 4, single window portal will be developed to facilitate and monitor the river and sea cruises. Facilitate and monitor the river and sea cruises. For that, a portal will be, single window portal will be developed. And JNPT and VO Chidambaranar Port to become smart port by the next year. So these are the 5 immediate targets of the Ministry of Ports, Shipping and Waterways, and they are calling it as Panch Karma Sankalp. Very, very important news. Very, very important. So how much financial support this ministry will provide for promotion of green shipping? So that's 30%. Option A is the correct answer. Now 30% of what? ये भी तो है, 30% of what? 30% of the total cost जो भी आएगी green shipping के लिए. This project is being, you know, it will be implemented in PPP mode. So जो 30% होगा पैसा वो भारत सरकार लेगी, Ministry of Port का, rest shall be you know collected or rest shall be funded from the private players. ठीक है, आगे चलते हैं. Question number 6. Which PSU under the Ministry of Defence has launched GAIN's 2023 challenge to identify and encourage development of innovative solutions towards technological advances in shipbuilding by startups? Right, GAIN's 2023. So if you know the full form of GAIN's, you know the answer to this question, because GAIN's stands for GRSE Accelerated Innovation Nurturing Scheme 2023. That is the full form of GAIN's. So GRSE, what is that? Garden Ridge Shipbuilders and Engineers, which is a PSU under Ministry of Defense, right? GRSE is a PSU under Ministry of Defense, and this PSU has organized GAIN's 2023 to identify and encourage the development of innovative solutions towards technological advances in the shipbuilding process. Jo shipbuilding process hai usko technologically advance karne ke liye innovative solutions ko invite kiya gaya through this GAIN's 2023. I hope this is clear. The thematic areas were AI, renewable energy or green energy, and energy efficiency and efficiency enhancement. Alright. And last but not the least, it is a 2-stage process to help generate a large number of ideas in the area of how we can, you know, how we can produce innovation in the shipbuilding process. Alright. So the correct answer should be option D, GRSE Limited. Question number 7 पे आ जाते हैं. With which country has Ministry of Education launched a working group on education and skill development? So this was launched in virtual mode with USA. Ministry of Education and US Department of Education has launched India-US working group on education and skill development, right? And with this, we will see the collaboration between these 2 countries in the area of education and skill development, right? And during this meeting, discussions were held in these 4 areas, which are skilling and vocational education, number 1, certification and recognition, number 3, matchmaking between US and Indian higher educational institutes, and number 4, engaging with the private sector. These were the 4 points of discussion in this meeting between India and US. So what will be the correct answer? Option E, United States. Question number 8 पे आ जाते हैं, which is about FIPIC, Where was Forum for India Pacific Islands Cooperation, which in short is FIPIC? It is a multinational grouping for cooperation between India and 14 Pacific Island nations. So where this forum established? When was this forum established? Right, that is the question. This forum was established in 2014. But why it is in news? Because recently Prime Minister Narendra Modi has addressed the third forum for India Pacific Island Cooperation Summit in Port Moresby, which is in Papua New Guinea. Right? Port Moresby, which is in Papua New Guinea. This third forum took place there and Prime Minister Modi addressed that forum. Right? This was established in the year 2014. The very first summit took place in Suva in Fiji. The second one took place in Jaipur. And the third one now in Papua New Guinea at a port which is known as Port Moresby. Right? This much information is enough about this organization. We will not go into the details of this. Right? So, what is the question? When it was launched? 2014. Option C is the correct answer. Let's move ahead to question number 9, which is a question in short. But before that, if you want to have the PDF of this class, you can join the Telegram channel. The link is provided in the description. And if you want to have the if you want to clear the examination this year only, you can join this crash course, which is now available, which is available on the website. You can have the mentorship session, the detailed mock test with proper explanations. Baki classes PDF to hai hi, wo to koi baat hi nahi hai. Sab kuch detail mein aapko mil jayega isme. Question number 9. Whereas the Ministry of Chemical and Fertilizers, headed by Mansukh Mandavia, in association with Confederation of Indian Industry CII. Organized B20 engagement on International Conference on Chemicals and Petrochemicals, Sustainable Transitions through Green Tech and Digitalization. It was organized in New Delhi. What is B20, by the way? B20 is a, you know, it is a group of all the businessmen of the G20 member nations. Not all the businessmen, the prominent businessmen of all these G20 member nations. Okay? So you can say it is a business group of G20 member nations. Okay? Question number 10. Minister of Jal Shakti will be organizing the award distribution ceremony for the 4th National Water Awards in June 2023. In how many categories 41 winners of this edition will be felicitated? The first edition ke winner were felicitated in 2019, after that 2020, and then 2022, and this time 2023. So we'll discuss about the awardees once they'll be felicitated. But today, itna padh lete hain ki 11 categories mein awards diye jayenge. Option C. Which country is hosting the 16th Langkawi International Maritime and Aerospace Exhibition, which is one of the world's largest maritime and aerospace exhibition, right? And the very first exhibition was established in the year, was organized in the year 1991. Right? Malaysia is the correct answer. Langkawi is in Malaysia. Option C is the correct answer. Question number 12. To which neighboring country has Indian Railways handed over 20 broad gauge locomotives to further strengthen the bilateral relationship? Important question. This has been given to our neighbor, Bangladesh. Option C is the correct answer. And the last question for today, and an important question. Which forum has been established at the city level under Smart City Mission to advise and enable collaboration among various stakeholders? Smart City Mission was extended last year, I believe, till June 2023. So let's see what will happen in the month of June. Kya extend hoga ya sarkar ye bol degi ki humne sare projects complete kar diye. So we have to wait for that. This forum is Smart City Advisory Forum. Option B is the correct answer. Alright, so that is all for today. I hope all the questions and their explanations are clear. If you have any doubts, you can ask me in the comment section. Thank you so much for watching. Goodbye, take care, and God bless.